Good morning or good afternoon to everyone, and welcome to this webinar on RodiMet. Today we will focus on hydroxymethionine, the value-added methionine. Maybe you have watched the last live webinar with Dr. Pierre-André Guérard, Professor Mike Kidd and Dr. Jaap van Mingen on amino acids beyond building blocks. And to continue on this topic, we propose you today to speak about methionine among all other amino acids because of its specific status. In fact, methionine is an essential amino acid and is involved in DNA methylation, protein deposition, and other applications, and is also a precursor of cysteine. So, in fact, animals need to fulfill their requirement in methionine to reach their optimal performance. And feed producers have the opportunity to fulfill this requirement in methionine with various effective sources of methionine. For example, there is DLM methionine, which is the preferred sources of premixer or small feed miller. And then there is also liquid hydroxymethionine, which is the best option for a large feed miller and also integrators. And in fact, these molecules are chemically different, so they have different characteristics, and it will be the topic of discussion today. And to discuss all these subjects, I'm really pleased to welcome today two R&D nutrition researchers from the CERN, which is the Center of Expertise and Research in Nutrition of Adisseo, based in Commentry. So first, welcome to Dr. Dolores Batonon-Alevo, who is a global scientific solution developer at Adisseo.
Thank you very much, and hello everyone.
Thank you. And Dr. Yves Mercier, who is in charge of RodiMet scientific and technical support, also at Adisseo. So welcome, Yves.
Thank you, and good morning, everyone.
So as a start, I propose to have a closer look at the methionine source and their characteristics. So Yves, I propose to start by you. Can you give us some more information about these methionine sources available for a feed producer?
Yeah. In fact, it exists two main methionine sources in the field and is available on the market. The first one is the DL methionine, which is a powder form with a 99% purity. And the second one is the hydroxy analog of methionine, we consider as hydroxymethionine, which is a liquid form with 88% purity. In fact, these molecules are both synthesized by chemical processes, giving a mix of a D and L form at 50% each of these forms. And the animal have to transform this D form into L methionine in order it can be usable by the animal.
And Yves, to continue on this topic, can you give us the main difference between those molecules?
In fact, the main difference is the one DL methionine is a true amino acid with an amino group, and the hydroxymethionine, in that case, the amino group is replaced by an hydroxy group, which is transform into amino group later on. And the fact that this molecule has an hydroxy group instead of an amino group transform it into, we can say, an organic acid, and it confer it a specific acidifying value. And for instance, this molecule has a pKa of 3.4.
And Dolores, to continue, does this molecule structure that Yves just mentioned, so we have an amino group for DLM and an hydroxyl group for hydroxymethionine. So does this difference have consequences on the intestinal absorption by the animal?
Yes, Florian, thank you for the question. So yes, we do have some differences about the absorption. The first one for DLHMTBA is absorbed by passive diffusion and through active transporters, Na+, H+ transporters, which are common to monocarboxylic acids and named MCT1. On the other side, we have DL methionine, which is absorbed specifically using active transporters, which are common to all natural amino acids, like lysine, for example. And the other consequence is that DL-HMTBA is faster absorbed than DL-methionine. Like you can see on the graph, its absorption is completed by the end of the duodenum, while DL-methionine is mainly absorbed at a jejunal level, like other amino acids.
So if I well understood, and if you will confirm me that, both forms are finally L-methionine precursor. So what about the conversion of these molecules into L-methionine?
Yeah, Florian, you are totally right. In fact, they are both L-methionine precursors. And both of these methionine sources have to go through a different steps to be transformed into L-methionine to be usable by the animal. And this transformation or conversion is done through a specific enzymatic reaction using a specific oxidase or dehydrogenase, leading to obtain which we call the KMB molecule for keto-methyl-thio-butanoic acid, which is a complicated name, but what you have to get is that this molecule is a keto form, and this keto form do not have anymore the L or D form. After these steps, a second step of transamination will appear by taking an amino group from other amino acids and transform the molecule KMB into L-methionine that can be used by the animal for protein synthesis and other use.